Originally constructed in 1899 by the Alamogordo at Sacramento Mountain Railway, the Cloudcroft Lodge has served as one of the greatest summer and winter resorts. Unfortunately, on June 13, 1909, a tragedy struck the small village of Cloudcroft, New Mexico, as a disastrous fire destroyed the luxurious mountain resort. Reconstruction began almost immediately following the incident. By 1911, the lodge had reopened on its current site. The lodge has entertained a wide range of people, including Pancho Villa, Judy Garland, and Clark Gable. On August 31st, 1992, the lodge was ranked number 44 in the top 100 resorts in America. Three-story, Victorian-style, elegant European mountain inn has many magnificent features and activities that keep guests coming back for more. However, there was one feature of the hotel that has fascinated guests for decades. Rebecca Potter was a very flirtatious young chambermaid who lived and worked at the lodge in the 1930s. She had an extremely jealous boyfriend. One day, Rebecca was flirting with another man in the Red Dog Saloon when Daniel, Rebecca's jealous boyfriend, walked in. Daniel pulled her aside and told her to meet him in the forest. That evening, Rebecca and Daniel went into the nearby woods. That was the last time Rebecca was seen. Well, alive anyway.
Hi, my name's Lisa Thomasy. I'm the general manager here at the Lodge Resort in Cloudcroft. We are at the highest point in Cloudcroft. This is at elevation of 9,200 feet. It's the tower. It is where our friendly ghost, Rebecca, likes to be. Downstairs in the basement is where the chambermaid's living quarters were, and now it's where our offices are. Some of her other favorite places is the governor's suite. And all of the governors of New Mexico have stayed there, including Pancho Villa and Clark Gable. And so she likes that area because all the notable gentlemen have stayed there in the past. We had the Red Dog Saloon, and that's another favorite place of hers. She loved to dance. We used to have a jukebox and live entertainment playing there on the weekends. It was a real popular area. And of course the New Mexico law is that you have to close at 2 o'clock. And so when it was time to close, she still wanted to carry on. And so we would have a night manager that would stay here called the night auditor. And they just stop her from, you know, still doing things in the room. And the jukebox was playing music even though it was turned off. And Rebecca was, you know, supposedly dancing in there. And so they'd unplug it from the wall to make sure that there was no way that she can get the music on. And here we go again. She's actually, you know, putting the jukebox on. And it was a concern because the noise transfer in the hotel did upset guests that were sleeping on the second level, right above where the Red Dog Saloon was. So she is our legendary, beautiful, red-headed ghost.
Many people have encountered Rebecca's spirit.
Well, I've been here about 20 years, and I have had numerous experiences with Rebecca in the stores and around in the hotel, but one of my favorite ones that happened to me probably a couple years ago is I was standing here at the counter, and I had a catalog. I was looking through it to do an order, and suddenly, I have this little basket here that has baby bracelets in it. And suddenly, it just turned on its side like that. And it all by itself. And I mean, it's got a pretty big solid base. I mean, there's no reason for this thing to just suddenly tip over. And it tipped over and all the little bracelets fell out. Kind of with goosebumps, pick them up and put them back in the basket and ask Rebecca to please, you know, kind of leave my stuff alone. But Rebecca is big on moving things around in the shops for us and on several occasions hidden things from us. And over in the mercantile, we have a shelf that has books on it, and one day I'd gotten a big order of books. There was about 24 of them. and I didn't have time to put them all away, so I just stacked them up one on top of each other on the shelf. And the next morning when I came in, about half of them were laying on the floor. And I thought, well, that's kind of unusual, but I didn't think anything of it. And I picked them up and I put them back. And later that morning, the man that was our night maintenance security man came by and he asked me, he says, was there anything unusual in here this morning? And I said, well, no. And then I said, yeah. Some of the books were laying on the floor. And he says, ah. He said, last night late, he says, I was walking down the hall and he says, just out of the corner of my eye, I noticed some movement. And we have a full glass door in the mercantile. And he said, when I stopped and looked, he said, the books were falling off the shelf just one at a time, like somebody was pushing them off. He said, I stood and watched it for a few minutes and then I just kept going. He said, I didn't want to know. He said, I just walked on by.
Rebecca's very friendly. My first experience with Rebecca was before I actually came to this property. We have a sister resort in Midway, Utah, and I worked there, and the management team that was here, we would, you know, converse by phone often, and she called me on the phone right before I was due to be here on a trip, like a week before. And so they said, oh, the phone's for you, and it's Rebecca at the lodge. And I said, we don't have a Rebecca at the lodge. We didn't have an employee or a manager at the time working here. And so I said, that's really strange. So when I went to the phone and I answered it, of course there was no one there.
Rebecca's body was found buried in what is today's golf course. Some believe she still haunts the lodge in search of another legend. So, could the legend of Rebecca be true? Down the